for the sub. Like one of the controllers. There we go. There we go. All right. So let's get the side thrusters on the go. Level meters depth. I could take the right hand channel, which is, I think the white means good depth, or I could go down the really shallow channel and just see how far we can get. That seems like more fun. Let's do that. And look around using a thumbstick. Ideally I'd like that to be on a head tracking, but such is life. Can also zoom in. Got binoculars set up somewhere. little bit of side on. RPMs moving at 3 knots. I did try to download the official Rotterdam port charts, but I didn't find them. So I don't know what the speed limit is down here. I'm sure it's about 5 knots or something. We're going to be going a lot faster than that, I can assure you. I zoom out, you can see just how detailed the map is. It's quite incredible, really. And this left hand channel is very shallow, like really shallow. So I have to be really careful. It's also not meant to be capable of doing triple screen. I had to sort of force it to do that, and it'll do it for a while, but eventually it will crash. But it is early access, so take that into consideration. There's some buoys out here. It's off the bow. It's obviously not windy today. None of those wind turbines are turning. Tight, not just on hitting that groin, but like I say, it gets really shallow really quickly. One, two. Just checking that the recording is working. Scary close that is. We'll try and stay inside of these buoys. Covering that cam, sorry. Good. You see those floating groins? There's a red one there. We are way too close to this one. But we're just inside of it, so I think we're going to be okay. Truth be told, we're moving way too fast. What are we doing? 22 knots. That's probably 4 or 5 times what we should be doing. Keep things safe. Starboard side, just inside that groin. There's another one coming up, just inside that groin. If you look on the markers, you can see we're 3 meters depth at the front, 2.9, 2.7, 2.6. We've got to keep it at least 3 meters. Oh, look at this. We are rocking. I think we just maybe tapped the bottom there. See, we've got a 3-degree roll going on. And I think that is down to us touching the bottom. So 3.5 meters at the front and at the back. 2.6 meters at the front. Yeah. There's no sound when you bottom out. I guess that's something that's coming in time. Really got to try and stay central. You see the markers? They've come in. So we were way too close to them, really. Got ourselves a nice bit of rock going on. Oh, hello. That was a different weapon there. Harbour Master over on the left. We're definitely travelling too fast here. Turning in too sharply as well. Put a bit of side on. Centralize. Getting awfully close on that starboard side. That's scary close. Straightened out. Final marker is very close. I have to come hard over to port. I should have perhaps practice this first. Yeah, we've got a bit of rock going on. We're going to run aground here. Oh, that should be making all sorts of horrible noises. There's the marker, we're trying to get into the starboard side of that. Gonna be awfully close. Oh, look at it. We're in full reverse. This is what happens, unfortunately, after a while. I think we're just inside of it. I think we're good. So we could put the throttles back on. Centralize. I think we're back in control. Down to 9.4 knots, which is still way too fast for this area. Bit of boat rock going on. Point 7, 3.5, 3.4 under keel. We should be fine, we should be fine. So I think what everybody would like to see are, you know, a multiplayer experience with other ships coming down the same channel as you, or even AI ships coming down the same channel would be fine. Things like this bridgeway here, maybe that should be active, occasionally causing unexpected or just a variation, something to keep an eye on, rather than just staying in the channel. And definitely, you know, you want to be able to pull up to a dock and start offloading your cargo and stuff. All of those awesome things. Look at that though, isn't that cool? Right, now there are some really tight turns coming up. There's no way no way on earth we're going to get through them at this speed, so I'm going to have to slow down. Or you're a bit of a wide boy, you can put full side thrusters on and line yourself up for a bit of a chicane handbrake turn. I think that could be fun. We're going to crash if I don't do something about this. Okay. See my handbrake turn approach coming up. Take off the side thrusters. Start turning in. Let's just tear it up. Let's just go for it. Full speed, see what happens. Side thrusters. Consider this to be like a power slide. Definitely got more on the left to play with, but only till we get around that corner, and then it's going to be emergency stations. We are close to those boys. anything to the right of those buoys, and we're going to be running aground. Even here, look. You see that lean? That's because we're too close to the edge of the channel. And it's 2.1 metres at the back. We're back into 3 metres. We're just too close, basically. So the ship, we've got a 7-8 degree roll going on. We can do this, we can do this. When can I turn? I think now. I think now is the time to turn. 15 knots, we lost 10 knots of speed when we ran aground. There we go. We're going to make it. Let the power slide commence. I cannot see the next buoy though. Damn, we are close again. Where's the next one? I see it, I see it. Now we're good. Yeah, we're good, we're good, we're good. Oh, 2.3 at the front there for a second. The echo sounded, but now we're in deep water. We're good. Point 5. Definitely shallow. Full thrusters to the right. And now we're going to power slide out the other side. Gonna be tight, but I think we can do it. I'm confident. Power slide begin. It may be a little bit too early. I think it's too early. If you really did this in Rotterdam, in a ship of this size, 35,000 tons or whatever it is, you wouldn't just lose your job and your license, you'd be arrested. You might even have to undergo psychological evaluation. I like this game. It's got a lot of potential. It's kind of like, not Microsoft Flight Simulator for boats, but more like FSX for boats. Somewhere in between the two. Awesome fun, I tell you. really enjoying this experience. Now we are running close here. We're not as close as we were on the starboard side, but close nonetheless. Take a look at this chart, see what we're going to do. So there's a really thin channel, but it's deeper. So it really opens up, the depth really opens up. We could go pretty much either way, really. Curious how far I could go. I think we're going to turn right here. There is a section there that's incredibly shallow, and that may be as far as we can go, but just here, look. I'm not sure if we'll be able to get past that bit, but we'll have a bloody good go. Right, that's enough sideways to the right. We're going to come back over as far as we can onto the port side. And then we're going to basically try and line this up so that we can turn in super hard. We're going to crash anywhere, it's going to be on the next corner. I've also got to make sure I don't turn down the wrong one. Right, let's get the side panel, the side thrusters off. Oh, what did we hit? 1.5 meters. Oh, there is no depth this side at all. These markers are in the wrong place. That's a 9-degree roll we got going on. See, look, we're inside of the marker, but the water depth was less than 2 meters there for a second. Oh, good now, it's 4 meters. 6-degree roll. We got it under control. See how the cameras start to flicker and fade after a while. Like I say, it's an early access game, it's not really meant to be doing anything quite as advanced as what I'm trying to do with it yet. But hopefully it will in time. I have to time this to perfection if I'm going to get the turn right. Almost certainly going to get this wrong. This is my first go at this, by the way, guys. This is the first time I've set this up, first time I've recorded it. It's all an experiment. It's just a bit of fun. I have no idea how well it's going to turn out. But I'm just going to stay positive and hopeful. Start turning in and getting ourselves lined up for this hard handbrake turn. Ah, this is crazy. It's a shame that the lighting is breaking like it is. Right, maximum port thrusters. Really get ourselves turned out hard. I actually can't see, if I'm being honest, where the turn is. I'm a bit nervous. Alright, I think I see it. Not 100% sure I see it. Oh dear. I've turned way too hard there. Way too hard. Maximum starboard thrusters required. This is where it all goes wrong. Look how far I've turned out there. That's crazy. We may be able to keep this on the right line. Maybe. Oh, it's going to be tight. It's like proper power sliding down here right now. Here we go, here comes the turn. ...0.1 meters below the front of the ship, we have run aground. I'm just hoping we've got enough momentum to push over it. 7 degree lean. Down to 1.7 knots. This could be us. But we might be run aground here. We might be able to get round still. Definitely not going to take it at full speed. ...9 degree roll. We have got water underneath us, so I think we'll be alright here. Just enough water. I'm sure we do. Damn it. I turned too hard too soon. We are grounded. So close. The turning we were looking for is just there. You see it? Spins off up round there. That's why I was really coming in hard. We were so close to pulling that off as well. That was good fun though. I did enjoy that. But yeah, we are well and truly grounded. Just got to wait now for the port police to come and arrest me. Throw me into prison for being a lunatic. Anyway, first look, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. I think it's a lot of fun. I think it's got a lot of potential, a lot of promise. And if they keep delivering on their promises and improving on the graphics and the scalability of the program itself, then I think it's going to be excellent fun. Oh, do you know what? It's a good job I didn't go that way, because there's a bridge down there that I wouldn't have been able to get through. Where you live and learn. All right, let's wrap this up. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.